श्रीमान् वेङ्कटनाथार्यः कवितार्किक केसरी वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि रामानुजदया पात्रं ज्ञानवैराग्यभूषणम् श्रीमद्वेङ्कटनाथार्यं वन्दे वेदान्तदेशिकम्
शीरुन्ऋतूपुल्तिरुवेङ्गडमुडयान् पारुन्रच्चोन्न पझमोळिळुळ् ஊருன்றுதானே அமையாதோ தாரணியில் வாழ்வார்க்கு வானேரப்போமளவும் வாழ்வு.
சர்வேஸ்வரன் ஒரு த்ரேதாயுகத்திலே, தட் மீன்ஸ் மெனி த்ரேதாயுகா மெனி ராமாஸ் வேர் தேர். ப்ளீஸ் ரிமெம்பர் திஸ் ஒன். ஸோ இட் வாஸ் எ ரெபிட்டிஷன், இட் வாஸ் நாட் அ வாட் யூ கால் மனோட்டனஸ் ரெபிட்டிஷன். But every time, because we forget our earlier births, and therefore it is always new. Lord is always new. Navo navo bhavati jaya manaha, scripture says. So every time he is born new. So Chakravarti Tirumahanai avataritta kalathile, we are always referring to the father, the race, the family, the clan, and so on. Dasharatha was the real Chakravarti. Chakravarti, as you know, monarch, emperor, king of kings. And his name is Dasharatha. And Dasharatha, the word Dasharatha has got a special meaning. Dasha meaning, you know, 10. So Ratha meaning the chariot, as you know. Both words are familiar. But Dasharatha is, he can drive his chariot in all 10 directions. How can you have 10 directions? We know 4 directions. We know next 8 directions. You know, east, south, west, and north. And then southeast, southwest, and south, northeast, and north, west. We all have. So up and down, 10 directions. His chariots can go up to heaven, namely Swarga. And then he can plunge into the depth of the nether world. He can go to any world, underworld. So Dasharatha, he drives in 10 directions. And I think I have already told you last time the meaning. Dasha meaning bird. Dasha meaning bird, B-I-R-D. Kite, K-I-T-E. Garuda, otherwise named. So Ratha is chariot. So whose chariot is Garuda? It is Rama, rather Sriman Narayana. So Chakravarti Tirumahanai. In Ramayana it is said, he chose the father. In Krishnavatara also, he chose the mother. In Krishnavatara, he chose the parents. Of course, mother is important there, Devaki. Here it was father. And Kausalya had 12 months pregnancy. It's very peculiar. Normally 9 to 10 months. So 12 months pregnancy. Just like an elephant. Elephant has got always 12 months pregnancy. The cub is very valuable. All the bones of the elephant are what we call made up of a costly material. All the bones, not only the danta, not only the tusk, but all the bones of the elephant are valuable. And you say ivory tusk. It's very costly. That's why we have a Tamil proverb. Yanai irundalum ayiram pon. Yanai irundalum ayiram pon. You have to buy an elephant in a very high cost. So yani irundalum ayiram pon. So he is very valuable. So here Lord is always, Rama is always considered with a style of walking, G-A-I-T, like an elephant. Matanga Raja Gatihi. Gajagatihi. Remember the style of gate in Srirangam. Srirangam is known for its gate. திருமகனாய் அவதரித்த காலத்திலே ஸ்ரீ வால்மீகி பகவான் பிரம்மபுத்திரனான ஸ்ரீ நாரத பகவான் பக்கலிலே இவ் அவதார விருத்தாந்தத்தை சங்கேபேண சிரவணம் பண்ணி மேபி நாரதா டோல்ட் ஹிம் 24,000 ஸ்லோகாஸ் வேற பிரம்மா டோல்ட் ஹிம் ஹண்ட்ரட் க்ரோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்லோகாஸ் சதகோட்டி பிரவிஸ்தரம் தட் இஸ் ராமாயணம் பை பிரம்மா So Brahma's son, Narada, gave in a nutshell with 24,000 shlokas to Valmiki. And so Sankshepena, in brief, Shravanam Panni, he heard him. Valmiki heard Narada. Then Saraswati Vallabhanana, Brahma Vanudaya, Saraswati Vallabha, Vallabha is in English gallant, G-A-L-L-A-N-T. More chivalrous. The husband is more chivalrous. C-H-I-V-L-R-O-U-S. So Saraswati Vallabhanana, Brahma Vinodaya. So Lord Creator is more attached to his spouse, the goddess of knowledge. Prasadatale, by the blessing of Lord Creator. Pravruddhamana. So Vruddham is growth. Vruddhi, pravruddham, pravruttamana, it has come up in progress. It has progressed well, pravruttamana. So we are going to the next page. Before that, you have the usual known shloka from Bhagavad Gita. So, engira padiye. Now, anybody can easily read, therefore, please note where this four occurs. Four, number four, in the text. Maybe later, I don't know. So this one, Sarveshwaran. Sarveshwaran is denoted by Paritranaya Sadhunam, Vinashaya Chatushkutam, Dharma Samsthapanarthaya, Sambhavami Yuge. So he takes incarnation every era, and therefore he is Sarveshwar. He is protecting the good people, he is destroying the bad people, and he is establishing the righteousness in this world. And therefore, he is Sarveshwar, he is all leader, omnipotent. And then you have a Sanskrit sentence from script Ramayana. Machanda deva te brahman pravritta yam Saraswati. That pravritta is given in Sanskrit, Tamil, pravrittamana. What happened was, he says, Valmiki says, Machanda Deva, and it is a word of Brahma. So Machanda Deva, because of me, my will. So if it is Brahma's will, it is Lord Sriman Narayana's will. So Chandaha, there are two meanings here. One is at will, chandaha. In another meaning is scripture. So Vedaha Prachetada Dasi Sakshat Ramayana Arpana. The scripture became Ramayana. Therefore chandas. So machandha is my scripture. My will. Two meanings. Third meaning is my poetry. My poetry, that meaning my prosody. Meaning there are 8 syllables in each quarter and there are 32 syllables in each verse, in all the 24,000 verses. Almost, because only in certain cases where the canto ends, it ends with a bigger verse, more than 8 syllables per quarter. So 32 syllable quarter is called shlokaha in Sanskrit, and out of the 256 varieties. Please note, very difficult the computer science to calculate in Sanskrit. And shloka has 32 syllables in a particular pattern. So fifth syllable will be light in every quarter. Sixth syllable will be heavy. And seventh syllable will be alternately heavy and light in odd quarters and even quarters. So that is the definition of shloka. So you have 256 varieties where there are 8 syllables per quarter in Sanskrit. Shlokas. So every word is not, every verse is not called shloka. Please remember. So we have so many other names also. For example, you know the meaning, I mean, word in Tamil called student, meaning student. You know, we say in Tamil, manavan. Manavan is student. But a small, I mean, younger student will be manava kaha. Manava kaha is younger student. Manavaha is a student. But of course, when you put what you call tatha dadana, then namely dental, manavaha is manushyaha. Manavaha is a human being. Manavaha is student. And manava kaha is younger student. Lower standard. And manavakaha, manavakam is the name of eight-syllabled quarter in Sanskrit. This is only one example. Out of 256 varieties, I am giving one more example beyond shloka and manavaka. And we have what we call a name called Vidyunmala. Vidyunmala. Vidyutu meaning lightning. Vidyutu meaning lightning. Mala means garland, as you know. So a garland of lightning. A garland of lightning. It's called Vidyunmala. These are all feminine, beautiful names where we are attracted by those names in the prosody, field of prosody. Prosody is called Niruktam. Niruktam is called, sorry, Niruktam is etymology. Chandas. Chandas is prosody. So we have generally about 26 varieties. Generally 26 varieties are popular, and among them only 10 are very famous. So if you write more than 26 syllables in a quarter, that becomes a common name, Dandakam. Remember Swami Vedanta Deshika's Garuda Dandakam and Kalidasa's Shyamala Dandakam. And recently a great scholar wrote Komala Dandakam, which is known to Shanti Mami here. Komala Dandakam. There are two Komala Dandakam books, and two great scholars wrote Komala Dandakam. It contains more than 27 syllables in one quarter. So totally 108 Swami Vedanta Deshika wrote in Garuda Dandakam. 108 is a significant number, unique number. Whatever we say for 108, 1008, 10008, lakh and eight, and so on. All, you know, the 8 plus 1 is 9, and 9 is a very peculiar number, magic number in mathematics. So you have, these are all some details for. So we cannot call any verse as shloka, please remember. We may call any prayer as stotram. Stotram is different from shloka. So Ramayana contains a lot of stotras like Aditya Hridayam and so on. So in Balakandam, in the second canto, 31st verse is Machanda Deva Te Brahman Pravarteyam Saraswati. Valmiki is addressed by Brahma. And Brahma in turn has got Antaryami Sriman Narayana. And therefore, you can take it as the statements either of Lord Creator or of Lord Sriman Narayana. So what happened was, Saraswati, the fund of knowledge, don't call it now goddess of knowledge, the fund of knowledge started out from my will, my scripture, and my prosody. That's a statement of Lord Creator. And it is said in Ramayana Champu, a very interesting book with our small, actually, what you call abridgment of Ramayana. He says, the king is called Bhoja. He says, Saraswati Nissasa. Before Brahma came and blessed Valmiki, the wife was in a hurry. So the wife wanted to take the name, name and fame for teaching Valmiki, Ramayana. And therefore, Saraswati Nissasa. Before Brahma came and blessed Valmiki, goddess of knowledge, namely Saraswati, came to his tongue and made Ramayana the composition. Now we can look at the words. So let me request Raghuramanji to read both the text in the commentary and the Sanskrit verses in the page 6.
திவ்ய சாரத்வ சாரஸ்வதத்தை உடையவனுமாய் பிரம்மாவாலே தத்துவவரனுமாய் ரகசியம் ச பிரகாசம் ச யதவ்ருத்தம் தஸ்ய தீமதஹ ராமஸ்ய சஹ சௌமித்ரே ராட்சசானாம் ச சர்வஷஹ வைதேஹ்யாச்சாபி யத் வ்ருத்தம் பிரகாசம் யதிவா ரஹஹ தச்சாப்ய விதிதம் சர்வம் விதிதம் தே பவிஷ்யதி நதே வாஹருதா காவ்யே காசிதத்ர பவிஷ்யதி என்று தெய்வீகமான வாக்கை உடையவனாய் இது ஒன்று தெய்வீகமாக வாக்கை உடையவனாய் ரெண்டு கொடுக்கப்பட்ட வரத்தை உடையவனாய்
Only this is Tamil transliteration, so we need not read that. So you have in the Balakandam, in the second canto, continuing after 31st verse, so 33 to 35 are quoted in page 6 here. So you understand very, very easily the details of the boon, granted by Lord Creator. That's what we see here. Divya Saraswatate Udayavanamai. So Valmiki became so endowed with divine knowledge. Divya and divine Saraswatam knowledge. I think you know the word Saraswati very well. The word Saras, as you know, look at the word Saras, S-A-R-S-A-S, Saras. Saras means lake. So Vati meaning full. Vati meaning full. Full of lake. Doesn't mean full of water, but full of knowledge. Here the lake is full of knowledge. He has a fund of knowledge. He has a what we call pond of knowledge. He has an ocean of knowledge and so on. So he expanded to the ocean. So Divya Saraswatate Udayavanamai. So Valmiki was very much blessed with divine knowledge, and Brahma Vale Datta Varanamai. So he has been granted boon by Lord Creator. And how was it? So how did he understand his blessing, that boon? Whatever happened during Rama's incarnation, he is not hidden from the view of Valmiki. So no secret has been hidden. No secret has been hidden from the Valmiki's views. And everything will be open, revealed, prakasham chan. Yadvrittam. Sorry, there is a small line missing. Yadvrittam. It is not yadavrittam. So yadvrittam tasya dhimataha. We are referring to tasya dhimataha in Rama's. Rama was a hero. And Rama's secrets, that is divine secrets, and Rama's biography, Rama's story, Rama's life incidents, all will be revealed to Valmiki. So nothing will be hidden from his view. Takasyam cha prakasyam cha yadvrittam tasya dhimata. So Ramasya, the word tasya dhimata will go with Ramasya. Saha saumitre. Along with Lakshmana, Saha along with Saumitre, so you know Sumitra's son. So Valmiki will understand the secrets behind Lakshmana's actions also, activities, Adishesha's incarnation. And Valmiki also will understand all secrets about the demons involved. There are a lot of demons involved, scores of demons. lakhs of demons involved. So Rakshasanancha Sarvashaha. So every character in Ramayana will be understood very clearly by Valmiki. Then this is very important. Vaidehyaschapi yadvrittam. Why did Sita incarnate or appear? We say avirbhavaha. Please remember, Sita did not incarnate. Sita appeared. Avirbhavaha. So Vaidehi, why did she appear in the sacrificial king, rather royal sage, namely Janaka? Then what happened? What did she do with Rama? So all these are all open to frankly known by Valmiki. So Vaidehyaschapi yadvrittam. So not only of Rama, but also his spouse. He knows everything. And Prakasham, so it is open, it is revealed. Yadiva raha, even if it is a secret, that will be revealed here. So that will be revealed to Valmiki. So this is part of the boon. The part, these are all amshas of boon. The ingredients of the boon. So tatucha api abiditam sarvam. Suppose Valmiki feels that something is unknown. So whatever has been unknown earlier by anybody else will be known to him. So he is being addressed now. Valmiki is being addressed by Narada here. So tachapi aviditam sarvam. Whatever has been unknown, viditam te bhavishyati, will be known by you. Now, then this is very important. Nate vaku andrita kavye. This is called kavyam. Book. So kavehe kritam kavina kritam kavyam, we say. Written by, composed by a poet is called Kavya. A good poet. And this is called Adikavya. Ramayana is called Adikavya. First poetry. First ornate poetry. First court poetry. These are some names in English, that's all. To confuse us. So nothing peculiar. So Kavyam, in the Kavyam, Te Kavya, in your work, Vak na andrita. Your speech will be, your words will be always truthful. Always truthful. Andrita, lie, L-I-E. So all will be false. Na andrita, nothing will be false. In this 24,000 slokas, you will not say any lie. So what is called as is various condition. So we say iti iha asa. Therefore it's called iti ahasa. Iti, thus, ha, there are two kinds of separation. Iti, ha, asa. It is surprising that what happened, happened. Iti, ha, asa. Iti, thus, here, asa happened. Asa was. Asa means was. So, kachi datra bhavishyati. So, nothing will be untruth in Ramayana. Atra here, meaning in the Kavyam. So, Bhavishyati will be. So, the whole Ramayana will be a true Kavyam. So, we have so two meanings here in Tamil. Daivikamana Vakke Vadevana. So, what we saw in the Sanskrit word in given in Tamil. So, Daivika Saraswatate Vadevana. So his words are also divine. His words became divine because of the blessings from both Saraswati and Brahma. And Kudukapatta Varate Udayavanai. We saw the word in Tamil, Datta Varate Udayavanai. Datta given.
Uddimanana Raman Udayavum, Lakshmanan Udayavum, Rakshasargal Udayavum, Sitayan Udayavum, Ragasya Mahavum, Prakashamagamum Ulla, பிரித்தாந்தங்களெல்லாம் உனக்கு தெரிய வரும். நாரதரிடம் கேட்காமையால் உனக்கு தெரியாதவை முற்றும் தெரிய போகின்றன. நீ செய்ய போகிற இந்த காவியத்தில் உன்னுடைய வார்த்தை ஒன்றேனும் பொய்யாக மாட்டாது.
This is what we just now saw in the words, verses from 33 to 35 in the Balakanda, in the second canto.
So na Saraswati la first na vatana irukkaradha vandu actually pullingathla vat appdin varu sreelingathla vatin varu so vatingaradha na enna nanichana like ngaradhukku like lake pola appdin na nanichana ana innikku dhan purinjadhu adha vandu completely like adha full லேக் அப்படின்னு
This is what is the advantage of joining a session. So, very good. So, வத்து means like. வத்து means like. இவ, as we say in Sanskrit. இவ. சத்ருஷஹா. சத்ருஷஹா we say. சமம். சமம். So many words for இவ. So, So very very nice understanding. So vattu means eva. So Saraswati meaning like the lake, like the lake. Okay. So the lake is very big. You must imagine that the lake is very big, not a small lake. That's why I in one of the sessions I told the people here, our friends, namely you must go to Kurukshetra to understand what is the lake, what is a big lake. In Shahar, as you know, in Hindi, you say city, Shahar. So you have
Brahma, Brahma Sarovar.
Very good, very good. Two big lakes.
Mm-hmm.
And Chengalpattu Lake, right? Keshavdas says Chengalpattu Lake. Shambarampakkam Eri. To be exact, Shambarampakkam Eri. It supplies water to Chennai. Therefore, so very good. So, whereas this Brahma Sarovar, what Harini says is, border is not seen by ice. Border, the other bank is not seen by the ice. In a city, in the city limits, please remember, they have not spoiled the situation, the natural situation. So, in Chengalpattu, So, here you have your beautiful lake. So, now, Saraswati is like a lake of knowledge or vatta as you understand today, full. Very good. Now, as you understand, as you correctly said, Saraswan is the Pullinga Shabda and Saraswati is the Srilinga Shabda. Very nice. So, Saraswan, there also you understand that a man of scholarship, good scholarship is called Saraswan. Page 7. தர்ம வீரிய பிரசூதமான திவ்ய சக்ஷுசாலே இவ் அவதார விருத்தாந்தத்தை நிரவசேஷமாக சாட்சாத்கரித்து லெட் அஸ் ஸ்டாப் ஹியர் அண்ட் தென் வி வில் கோ டு தி வேர்ட் முமுக்ஷுவுக்கு லேட்டர்
ஹசிதம் பாஷிதம் சைவ கதிர்யா யச்ச சேஷ்டிதம் தத் சர்வம் தர்ம வீரியேண யதாவத் சம்ப்ரபஷ்யதி பணாவா மலகம் யதா பணாவா மலகம் யதா என்னும் படி தசேந்திரியானன் கோரம் யோ மனோரஞ்சனீச்சரம் விவேகசரஜாலேன சமம் நயதி யோகினா என்கிறபடியே
Can you read the single Tamil line, next line?
Varatin mahimayal untana divya drishtiyale.
In Balakandam, in the third canto, the fourth verse is this. Now, what is it given in Sanskrit text, I mean Tamil text in the commentary is Dharma Virya Prasutamal. We have got two types of virility, power of production. Power of production is called virility. Sanskrit viryam. So it will be dharma viryam and adharma viryam. There are two types. So you can use the power to destroy or you can or create. You can be right or wrong. You can be righteous or maladministered. So here we are talking about the right way. So dharma virya prasutam. So born from what was the dharma virya? say the boon of Brahma. The boon of Brahma is called dharma virya. The power given to Valmiki, and therefore it's called dharma virya. Brahma advised him with the good aspects. So Valmiki received it in the good spirit. So nothing wrong there. Nothing negative in what Valmiki received from Brahma. And therefore, dharma virya prasutam. Prasutam delivered. So varatin mahimeyal undana. What happened? What was the result? Divya chakshusale. Valmiki had a divine vision. And therefore, divya chakshusale. If avatar vrittantatai, the story of incarnation of Rama, niravasheshamaha, completely, all, Harini, please note, all are Sanskrit words. In between, there are one or two Tamil letters. So, you look at that, prasuta mana, the word mana, then chakshusale, ale, then iv avatar, that's only iv, first letter, iv, then vrittantatai, then nirashesha maha, maha, sakshat karittu ittu. Everything is Sanskrit. So niravashesha maha, completely, fully, sakshat karittu. That is what you call video format. Video format. But it is live video format. Please remember, it is not a replay. It is not what you call a flashback. Valmiki saw with his own eyes the video remaining in the forest where he was, he had a video, live video, what you call telecast. Live video telecast of all entire incarnation. Even he had the what we call fast forward. So instead of going back, that is going back, as we say, so this is fast forward. So fast forward also he knew. So Sakshat Karit, he saw with his own eyes. Then we are talking about. Now we go to the Sanskrit verse. Now, can you leave me the meaning, Harini? It is very easy. Hasitam.
The laughing, the speaking.
The laughter. Can say laughter. Hasitam,
the
laughter.
Laughter. And the...
Bhashitam,
the...
Bhashanam is Bhashitam.
Bhashanam and Gatihi. I guess the movement or the...
Very good. Movement. Travel. What is Bhashitam?
Bhashitam is communication or speech.
Very good. Communication. Good translation. Bhashitam is communication. Huh. You should not be my speech. This is communication. Very good. Communication. Yeah. Huh. And cheshtitam.
Cheshtitam. The activities are...
Very good. Activities.
Activities. So, tat sarvam dharma viryena. It was...
What did I say about dharma virya?
Dharma virya means Brahma, I guess. Dharma virya.
No, Brahma. Brahma's boon. Brahma's boon is called
Dharma. Brahma's boon. Okay. It was Brahma's boon. So.
Yathavat
samprapashyati means he visualized Yathavat. Yathavat, how to say it? Like as it is.
Your translation, visualization is okay, but he saw with his own eyes. Live telecast.
Live visualization, yeah.
Tat sarvam, everything. So, whose laughter, whose communication, whose movement, and whose
Rama's.
Not only Rama, very good.
Every character of
Rama. Very good, Rama. Every character. Rama, so, for every character you have ya, yat, cha, eva. These are all words. In Sanskrit, Ramayana, Valmiki is every letter is very important. Every letter is important. So, Hasitam, Bhashitam, Chaiva, Gatihi, Cheshtitam, only four aspects are given. Laughter, communication, movement and activity. Only four are there. What about other things? There was war, fight, there was advice, there was scolding. Bharadwaja found fault with Bharata. Bharata scolded Kaikeyi. What about everything? So, cha eva, cha and etc. etc. Again, ya, yat, cha. Gatihi ya, the movement, any movement. So, yat, cha. Again, so many other what happened. So many other things which happened. Tat sarvam. So, this is what you call the small letters also, single lettered words also give us some meaning. Very significant. Just one example that I give you from Balakandam. So, Valmiki was asking Narada, I want to see a person with the 16 qualities. 16 qualities, 1-6. So first one he says, Dharmajnaha. One who knows propriety, who knows what is called righteousness. So Dharmajnaha. So next word is cha, dharmajnyascha, kritajnyascha. The letter cha, you know, has meaning and also and so on. So the cha will say, adharmajnyaha, ramaha, adharmajnyaha. Rama knows what is right. Rama knows what is wrong also. Dharmajnyaha, cha meaning, adharmajnyaha. He knows the right and wrong. So that's the meaning. So these are all what you call in Sanskrit, in the single lettered words in Mahabharatam as well as Ramayanam are very significant, meaningful. So no letter is wasted in the Ramayana. No syllable is useless in Ramayana. So that is, meaning. So wherever there is a laughter and communication, travel and activities, all were understood by Valmiki. And then, what type of understanding? How will you say? Tamil or proverb, Raghuramanji or Seshadri Swamiji, Solamudima, Tamil or proverb. அது வந்து எல்லாம் கிளியரா இருக்கு தமிழ்ல சொன்னா எல்லாம் கிளியரா இருக்கு எவ்ரிதிங் இஸ் கிளியர் இன் தி சப்ஜெக்ட் சோ ஹவ் டு யூ சே இட் இன் தமிழ் ப்ராவர்ப்
உள்ளங்கை
நெல்லிக்கனி உள்ளங்கையில் நெல்லிக்கனி அதுதான் பாண பாணவ் ஆமலகம் ஹரிணி ப்ளீஸ் நோட் இட் இஸ் பாணவ் என்ன விபக்தி சொல்ல முடியுமா வாட் இஸ் த விபக்தி ஆஃப் பாணவ் ஆமலகம் யதா ஆமலகம் இஸ் கூஸ்பெரி நெல்லிக்கனி ஆமலகம் இஸ் கூஸ்பெரி சரி இன்னொரு ப்ராபர்ப் இருக்கு இந்த ப்ராபர்ப் யார் சொன்னாங்க உள்ளங்கை நெல்லிக்கனி யார் சொன்னது
அடியான் சுவாமி
சரி அப்படி இன்னொரு ப்ராபர்ப் இருக்கு கொஞ்சம் நெகட்டிவா இருக்கும் உள்ளங்கை நெல்லிக்கனிங்கிறது பாசிட்டிவ் கையில வந்து நெல்லிக்கனி நெல்லிக்கனி வாட் யசோதாஸ் ரோட் இஸ் நெல்லிக்காய் இல்ல நெல்லிக்கனி ரைப் ஃப்ரூட் ஆஃப் கூஸ்பெரி
இன்னொன்னு கை புண்ணுக்கு கண்ணாடி வேண்டாம்
வெரி குட் வெரி குட் வெரி குட் தட் இஸ் லிட்டில் நெகட்டிவ் கை புண்ணுக்கு கண்ணாடி வேண்டாம் கண்ணாடி வேணுமா வேண்டுமா கை புண்ணுக்கு கண்ணாடி வேண்டுமா வெரி குட் சோ தேர் இஸ் நோ மிரர் நெசசரி டு லுக் அட் தி hands wound in the hands very good paanav amalakam yata just like now look at harini look at the previous word previous verse yathavat can you tell me the meaning of yatha and vat
yathavat as it is
you said vat means like Vata means
like.
Yatha means?
Yatha.
So what do you say for new and new? Navam navam. Navam navam. You say the word navam navam. Venkatadri Swami in his Lakshmi Sahasram uses this. Navam navam. You have heard about what do you call again and again in Sanskrit? What are the words for again and again? Any idea? Can you?
Punah punaha.
Punah punaha. Punaha. Again. Again. Very good. Punah punaha. Yeah. And some other word? Apadam apahartaram dataram sarvasampadam loka viramam sriramam. Anybody?
Bhuyo bhuyo.
Very good. Another type? Muhuhu. And again another type is varam varam. So it is in the Navagraha Kirtana of Muthuswami Dikshita, you say varam varam. On Tuesday, what do you call, the Mars planet is sung. So varam varam. So every day, every time. Bajagovindam. Bajagovindam Mudhamati. So you have a lot of words. So yathavati is just like that. And yathaya meaning, as you know, as. So it also means like. But here vati is full, as usual. So yathavati is as and full. That means complete picture has been got by Valmiki. Very good. So now next, please. So Parnav, what is the Vibhakti I was asking? So it's very, because you are here. So Parnav, what is the word, basic word? What is the word for hand?
Pani,
very good. Pani.
Pani Grahanam,
catching of the hand. So Pani Grahanam is an eclipse which doesn't leave us at all. Eclipse ends, but not Pani Grahanam. Surya Grahanam or Chandra Grahanam. Solar eclipse and lunar eclipse end. Whereas we don't, the Pani Grahanam will not end. Okay, so Pani is hand. So Amalaka, Pano is what, Vibhakti? Can you give me the case? I think, have you been trained in English medium or Sanskrit medium?
English medium.
Okay, oh, no. Then what is the case?
Second case.
Not case is Pano.
Parno means meaning.
Meaning means
Hasta.
Parno.
Haste. Parno is not Dvivachanam.
Not Dvivachanam.
Keshavdas gives the meaning. The locative case. Okay. Saptami Vibhakti. Eram Mitra.
It's like vidhi without, like that only, no? Vidhi.
No. Pani hi pani panayaha. How does it look like? Matihi mati matayaha. Last Saptami Vibhakti is matau. Matyam matau. That is Srilinga. Here it is Pullinga Shabda. Therefore, pano. On the hand. In the hand, over the hand, above the hand. So, Amalakam. So, gooseberry. Okay, next. Next.
Swami, Pani is Pullinga Shabda or?
Pullinga Shabda.
Pullinga Shabda.
Okay. So, Dashendriyananam. I think Shanti Mami can give me the meaning. This is very beautiful philosophical meaning. Dashendriyananam Goram Yaha Mano Rajani Charam Viveka Shara Jalena Pani 2, very good. Second vibhakti, masculine. Right. Shanti Mami, can you give me the meaning and we will end the session with this. Dasha Indriya Ananam.
Dasha Indriya Ananam.
Whom are we referring to? Dasha Ananam.
Dasha Indriya Ravanan, is it?
Yeah. So how is it now compared to the 10 faces, 10 heads are
of Ravana.
Are likened to Indriya. No, let us take the word Indriyam. What is the meaning of Indriyam?
Indriyam is weapon or...
Sense organ. Our own sense organ. Sense organ.
The ten organs.
Okay.
All the, senses.
That is what we say. So the 10 heads are the 10 sense organs. Karmendriyani 5, Jnanendriyani 5.
Yes,
5. So Ghoram.
Ghoram is
terrible. Ghoram is terrible.
Awful.
Awful, right. Terrible. Frightening. Mano Rajani Charam. Rajani. Mano. So what is Ravana in his mind? What is Rajani? Rajani means Nisha. Nisha means Chapa. Chapa means Chanada. Rajani Kantaha is moon. Moon appears in clearly bright in
Purnima.
Night. Rajani Kant is moon. Moon appears bright in night. So Rajani means night. Rajani Charam means Rakshasa. The demon always wanders at night. He is always wakeful at night.
Yes, they are awake in the night.
Right. So it has dark. He has darkness of ignorance. Yeah. Ravana has darkness of ignorance. Where? Darkness of ignorance where? Manaha. Tamil. Manas. So Manorajani Charam. We are talking of Ravana here. So we have to dismiss the darkness. How? Viveka Shara Jalena. We are now going through internet. We are now discussing through internet. What is it called in Sanskrit? Antarjalaha. Antarjalaha, internet. So we have a net of Shara, which is Viveka. What is Viveka? Tamilna.
Viveka.
Discrimination. Very good. Discrimination. Shara, arrow. So Jala is a fleet of arrows, a group of arrows. So by the discrimination called arrows, many arrows, what should we do? Yoginam Shamam Nayati. Rishinam Muninam Shamam, that is Niyamam Nayati. All our sense organs are under control. When we become yogis, when we become meditators, by using the discrimination power, namely the discrimination power is the arrows, then we can control all the 10 organs with the help of the mind which wanders at the ignorance, darkness of ignorance. Very nice. Thank you very much for participating. So this should be the type of what you call two-way communication. Otherwise, this will be, if it is one-way communication always from me, then how can you take interest? So each of you must have some part or other to play, role to play. This is in Tamil. Everything is in Tamil. Now, Raghuraman ji can read if you want. Only we have repetition. Shiritadam, Peshiyadam, சென்றதும் செயல் செயல்பாட்டுடன் செயல் செய்ததும் எவ்ரிதிங் இஸ் ஓபன் டு வால்விங்.
Look at
the transparency of Ramayana. Transparency of Ramayana. Today we call everything transparency. Everything transparent. We want every fact as transparent. So transparency was there in Ramayana. Nobody can hide anything from Ramayana.
ராமானுஜதயா பாத்ரம் ஞான வைராக்ய பூஷணம் ஸ்ரீமத் வேங்கடநாதார்யம் வந்தே வேதாந்த தேசிகம் கவிதார்க்கிக சிம்ஹாய கல்யாண குணசாலினே ஸ்ரீமதே வேங்கடேஷாய வேதாந்த குருவே நமஹ. சீரொன்று தூப்புல் திருவேங்கடமுடையான் பாரொன்ற சொன்ன பழமொழியுள் ஓரொன்று தானே அமையாதோ தாரணியில் வாழ்வார்க்கு வானேரப் போமளவும் வாழ்வு.
ஓம் நமோ நாராயணா.